hike, and everybody, here I am back at the fair. So somebody suggested that I should do a little cooking show here at the fair because I'm making a tagine in my booth with using just a little hot plate, which works great. I did this yesterday and it was a huge hit, and I swear more people came in the booth once they started smelling how good it smelled. So I've already cut up my vegetables. Today I'm gonna make a beef and prune tagine. It also has apricots. I know you may think prunes, eh, but it actually is one of my favorites. I love it. So what I'm going to do is put my tagine lid carefully aside. And then I'm gonna start this puppy up. I have some oil generously donated by the Loco Taco booth because I forgot to bring oil yesterday and I still have some left, so I figure I'll use it today. It's a little breezy today, so I'm having to hold down the fort here. My Koran tablet is swinging. It's making me a little nervous, but I think it'll be okay. Okay. So let's see. I have this heating up. Now, tagines do take a little while to heat up. So we'll let this sit here for a few minutes while I gather everything else together. Yes, tagine Moroccan. I have some almonds to snack on. Oh, excellent. Nice to see you. I actually did put up a few new things. I found them in my car. I'm like, oh, how about this?
You've been doing okay then today?
Well, yesterday was good. Yesterday was a good day.
I love that one. Well, I'm actually, I think this is a pretty powerful piece.
You know what?
I have to thank you. Without my...
So many people came yesterday and they were like, I saw this woman with this necklace on. Did you literally, tripled my
chance? They know me. They know, and this is who, I don't know who I'm going to be, but that's who I used to be. So I'd walk around and go, the energy coming out of this necklace. I'm not sure. One, did they just say honor who you were for so long because you're turning me into something else, or this is a harbinger of something else coming? It's okay either way. But you're right, it was raining and people were going, oh my God.
That yeah. I was like, wow, I love this woman.
I'm Nikki, incidentally. And you have Carolina.
Yes, I'm Carolina.
Yes, I know. I call everybody.
But you can call
me. I'm half Italian, so I call everybody.
Okay. The Italian I like.
I actually half grew up in Italy for Remo.
Oh, really?
It's Italian. Non è una storia,
I can be Carolina because I'm very passionate. Okay. That works for me. I guess the Spanish would work too because
I look this
also
up.
Passionate. Oh.
Gypsum. So am I. It isn't recorded stone, semi-precious stone.
Uh-huh.
So I wanted to look up, but I also, and this is what have been my old self. This is exactly what I was looking for years.
Really?
I mean, years.
It's so funny.
This.
I thought that one would sell immediately. And it's one that, like, everybody is like, oh, I love this so much. Nobody ever buys it. I don't think so.
Somebody's, this is, well, you know what, the right person.
Okay, so now,
you mentioned what the fibula is called?
The fibula.
What is
are
the fibula?
These what are these? They're used for attaching a headscarf to your dress.
Oh my gosh. This is what, like a waist necklace?
No, that's a necklace necklace. Those beads are called tagmut, and they are symbols of fertility.
What's the religion of Iran?
They're Islamic. Predominantly Islamic, yeah.
And what are these?
Those are the Southern Crosses. They're called Southern Cross or Tuareg Cross. So they represent the different tribes of Morocco. So the different shapes are from different tribes. I actually have my well-worn little guide here. So my partner, he's from this tribe and this tribe. So they're really cool. They're all different. And then this one is really different. I don't have them.
And then what
What about this? I'm just asking.
That's also a fibula. Like that one, like those, it's just smaller.
Would it attach a headdress? Or would
yeah. Or you could use it just as a, you know, a pretty pin. I love that one because it's so delicate.
God, it's gorgeous. And are you on island? You live here?
I live here year round. Morocco is a very special place.
Very intense place.
It's really pretty amazing. But this stuff has a lot of love in it.
Oh, I like your hot like that.
Oh, thank you.
There's a good way to cook real food while you're gone.
That's exactly. I got so tired of fair food that I wanted to do some real food.
I'm looking at once a year, I'm coming out to the Sephora.
Yeah, I know! That's where you guys were going to visit yesterday.
And other people would come really good. We're going to have to get for it because you know, I didn't like it.
I know. Maybe I should have that today because I've never had that. Yeah. So I talked to my partner this morning and I'm going to have a new shipment sent in. I'm going to do Tivoli Day too, I decided. Yeah, so I'll have new stuff then.
Until October 8th, I want to.
No, Tivoli's like September 17th.
Oh, Harbor Day, Harbor Fest Day.
Harbor's like earlier, maybe. Right. In June, I think, is Harbor Day.
So maybe something you want to get that.
Tivoli Day is just Tivoli Day. I don't know what exactly it's for, but. Please do. Support my life on
you
the vineyard.
No, I don't do it. And when I did what I did, I put it down and started walking away, and I go, if you're 20 minutes, you're so wonderful. Without fail, it's like, I walked 10 yards away, and the voice went, you have to get that.
Really?
Like, the voice was speaking. It wasn't me anymore. So.
I like that. I want more voices
speaking.
Yeah,
right.
It's not an easy place to live.
Where are you from originally?
I was born on the island, and then I moved to New York State, and then I moved to North Carolina. And then I moved to California. And then my grandmother has lived here since the 60s.
So I was going to say, how are you staying on the island?
Well, pardon? Yeah, exactly. That's how you do. I do. So we moved here to take care of my grandmother. So we moved in with her for about 5 years. And she left the house to me. So she deeded the house. So she's actually still alive. And she's in Windermere now.
Oh, she's in Windermere, so you do have a house.
Yeah, so I have a house, so I'm very lucky for that.
But
I still.
Without the cast, you have to go.
You guys are ready for the beach. Yes. That one is $800,
the one that's down below.
Oh, the big one? That one is $4,000. those are spices. Those are from a mountain town in Morocco called Chef Shoen.
What are you making?
I'm making a tagine, and this is a beef tagine with prunes, which sounds kind of gross, but it's so good. Mm-hmm. Prunes have a bad reputation in the U.S., but it's so good. It's literally one of the best things I've ever tasted.
Very good.
I know, it's my prized possession. I want somebody to buy it, but at the same time, I don't.
What is this one?
That one is $80. It would be more, but it needs to have a little repair done.
Ah.
It needs to have a clasp put on.
And
which
do you
is
know
nothing.
Anything about this piece? Mm-hmm. What is it? What is it?
So this is mixed metal.
Yeah.
And it's all hand etched. And so this is the Hamsa, or the hand of Fatima. So this provides protection and also good luck. So you'll see this everywhere in Morocco. You'll see it everywhere.
I was like looking at this going, five star pentacle.
Yeah.
So you'll see the repeating symbol, like the necklace I have.
Right.
I had some earrings, somebody bought those.
This is something else.
No, that's the same thing. They come in many different
forms. This comes from
them. Yeah.
Did you see the solar?
Well, this is the Hamsa with a spiral of light.
Right.
But the Hamsa you'll see all over Morocco. People have it painted on their doors, they have hanging on the wall, I have that big one over there, the Hamsa.
Right.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. That one's cool, huh? That one's a great wall. You know, I really wanted to do, like, I had this whole vision this year to put everything in my garage, put a sign out at the end of the road. Be open like on weekends. I work at the library.
Oh, right.
And it's just been insane. It's been
everything.
I have a lot of really big festivals that I do in the summer for the library. So the library is taking over.
Yeah, you're right.
It's stealing my dreams.
It's been really insane.
Yeah, it's been so busy. So maybe next year, because I'd like to do Chilmark and some. I think I'd like to do Chilmark. Everybody says that's the one where they think I should go. And I think that would be good.
Because this is very much a tourist trap. Chilmark is
it's more.
Yeah, you do really well.
I'm looking to get in there for sure.
Can you get in? Is it impossible?
Well, before I was, they don't want more jewelry and they don't want more textiles. So, but I have kind of all over the gamut.
Right.
So maybe I can get in. That way.
Also, there's only, there was a woman who, you should know this, there was a woman, you know Francesca Kelly?
I don't know.
Her daughter, Francesca Kelly, her daughter came, she's one of those multinationals.
Uh-huh.
Born and lived in India, lived in Monaco, so she and her friend, they're Europeans, did a trunk show here.
Oh, really? I tried to get into trunk shows this year, but I just haven't had anybody latch off. Because I thought that would be a lot of fun, too, just
right.
to do these, like, one-off shows.
Do really nice shows.
I just don't know how to get into that. How to break in.
Okay. Well, the thing is, you can do your own, but then you have to place, you have to somebody's home to do it, right? You need to have a trunk show at somebody's house.
Is that how it works?
Normally, trunk shows are at somebody's place, so.
I sense a missing child. It looked like it. I saw the worried look.
I really want to buy back some of these things. And I don't do that. I just don't do that anymore. Don't buy them. But I've taken pictures. I'm going to tell you for
that. You want that one? Would you like some tea? Oh, this does have a little green tea. It's the Moroccan mint tea.
And he's Moroccan?
He is Moroccan.
Do you have a picture of him?
Fantastic picture.
I just, there's so many stories.
I'll be back.